I just want to make a little comment about the limits of monetary policy, because the CBN governor slightly tried to allude to that, in the sense that we talk about a typical businessman faces, when he wants to do a project, thinks about risks and return. You know, that risk-return equation, you want to tilt it in the direction of making many more projects viable, so you have a lot more investment. So there's a serious problem when there are some risks that nobody is touching, which are making projects costly and so on, and they cannot be touched necessarily by monetary policy. You can touch some of those risks with monetary policy, but it's a big mistake to try and touch, to fight every problem with money. Because some problems, you fight them with money, you worsen them and you compound the problem. So the next thing I'm going to point out is the governor mentioned that we brought inflation from 18% down to 11% and so on. But you know, it's funny because I gave an interview the other day and said, CBN governors in Nigeria are very good at bringing down inflation when it gets to a level that is politically unacceptable, like 18, 19. When it gets near 10%, they get tired. And the thing now stays at 11%, 10% endlessly. There's no need for that. The same methods that brought it down to 18 from the 11 can bring it down to 5. Now, but it's true. If you have an inflation rate that is 11% year on year, US inflation rate is 2%. Every year you don't adjust, it's a 9% differential. The solution is not to devalue, but to bring down the inflation rate. Look, Aliko and I go back a long way. He's done phenomenally well. Obotu Deko has done phenomenally well. Jim, Mike Adenuga and co. Let me tell you what they all have in common. They are all very combative personalities. Because of that, no regulator will go to them and try nonsense. Because most of them know how to deal with that regulator. We have to move beyond that, making Nigeria an economy only for the few people who are very combative. Some of us too are combative enough, so people know what's in regulation. Now let me continue, because those we are destroying are the 22-year-old entrepreneurs, the 25-year-old entrepreneurs. This economy is rigged against the youth, and it's not going to grow. When Aliko and I were 30, we were allowed to grow. Today, we're killing the youth from growing. Lagos is the home of all those young entrepreneurs. Part of your responsibility is to protect them from these rogue regulators. Because Lagos is the hub. Power sector, there's some hope, a bit of hope, except that we're not doing the right things to complete the journey. The hope is that most of the problems can be solved if you bring all the participants together in a round table. And also, it's a problem that can be partly alleviated by a checkbook. The money that Nigeria squandered on AMCON, even one-third of that will resolve most of the issues in the power sector. Most of the issues. So, but call people together, stop fighting each other. The priority is to have an economy that works for every entrepreneur. The reason the economy is not growing is that there's no investment. Please don't get me wrong. When I say there's no investment, there's one massive investment in a refinery, one massive investment in something, one in something else. We need investments all over the place, every which way, for the economy to grow. Not even so much because of turnover, but also because of jobs. We cannot have a nation of 200 million people, of which we have 40 million youth roaming up and down with no prospects and no job prospects. Sooner or later, they'll pull the whole house down. So that's the priority. So please, as you go to your groups and so on, I can say a lot more, but I don't want to cause confusion in the room or to frighten people. So thank you very much.
The roads are getting busier and traffic congestion is intense.